Hello again everyone, it's Tiger Arcade, and today I wanted to do a brief overview of the DFAM, kind of like getting started. When I first started off with the DFAM, I wasn't really sure what to do or how to get the sounds or results that I wanted, especially after watching a lot of other videos. So I hope that this can kind of give you a general explanation of what, you know, the knobs do. We're not going to be going over the patch bay today. That can be saved for another episode. Kind of to get started, you know, as like a general description of the DFAM itself. The DFAM has three different sound sources. You have your VCO 1, VCO 2, and a white noise generator. And right here is a three-channel mixer. You have lots of sound shaping tools, and we'll kind of go over that. So you have your low pass and high pass. The low pass is a four pole low pass filter. The high pass is a ladder filter. So these are very powerful filters. Modulation, you know, you have three envelope generators with voltage controlled decay. Sequencing, you have an eight step sequencer with pitch and velocity control per step. Your patch bay, you have 24 different possible patch points. There's 15 inputs and 9 outputs. So if we get started, you know, the most obvious thing is this big red button right here. Run, stop, you know, it starts and stops the sequencer. You have the ability to set the pitches with these frequency knobs, and it's for each oscillator. So it can get wacky fast, but you know, that's the idea. If you're really trying to tweak your sound, a lot of times, you know, I'll just tweak it until things just start to sound right to me. If we want to add some punch, then we want to go to the VCO 1 envelope generator amount. And I'll show you that right here. That's this guy right here. Kind of hear that it gets a little bit more punchy depending on how you twist it. And what's happening is it's adding modulation to the oscillators. And modulating just means, you know, changing or altering the sound of something. The next step, we have the VCO decay right here. And with the VCO decay, you're going to add more motion to the pitch of the notes. You'll notice right here. And it works with the VCO envelope generator amount that we just messed with. So if you kind of play with both of those, you'll notice you'll get some pretty interesting effects. Let's try it out. Pretty cool. These are all just, you know, different ways for you to tweak your sound a little bit more. So with your sequencer here, you have pitch and velocity. Pitch, you know, is just like essentially choosing the note. And then velocity is kind of like bringing in and out that sound. How loud is that particular step? How quiet is that step? And that's kind of important when you want to emphasize certain parts of your rhythm. So we have a kick on 1 and 5, you know, because if we think of it in 4 steps, it's like do, 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 do. So what we'll do is we'll bring down everything between and then have a hit on the 3 and 7. So again, if we kind of break it up in steps of 4, it'll be do, 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 do. And we can bring up that however loud we want, again with the velocity, and then the pitch, we have it up all the way, and you get some higher notes, obviously, the higher up you bring it, and lower sounds, the lower down you bring it. So So with the sequencer pitch mod, this is a really important one as well that gets really overlooked. And then once I figured that out, I was able to really start to change the sound. Having it to VCO 1 and 2 really allows you to kind of take full control of the sound. Off, you know, as if, you know, if you wanted to just focus on the patch bay, I would say, you know, there's other uses for that too. But let me demonstrate that for you. You notice it's not like really picking up any particular pitch anymore. VCO 2. And it's just literally what it says it is. The sequencer pitch mod is modding the pitch for VCO 2 now. And if we set it to 1 and 2, we kind of get a full dynamic control. So definitely utilize that if you're really trying to tweak your sound. In addition, we have the ability to change the waveforms. You have triangle and square for each oscillator. Definitely square seems a bit more punchy. Triangle, you know, a little bit softer. And I think that is another great tool for shaping your sound. So let's demonstrate so you can hear the different oscillators. Because you have, remember, you have three different sound sources. You have two oscillators and one white noise generator. Let's hear those. So right now you're hearing just one oscillator. Let's bring in another. And now let's bring in white noise. Now, if we want to create some harmony, this is another really important switch, just like this one, the hard sync. And what that means is it's going to lock in the pitch to kind of follow along with this one. So no matter however you twist this, it'll kind of always follow the pitch or frequency of oscillator one. It's almost like it tames it to be working with everyone else a little bit nicer, because before it's just a little bit more free. And if that's what you want to do, that's why you have that option. So let's explore the FM knob. What it's going to do is it's going to modulate, again, we used that word before, it's going to modulate the frequencies. Let's turn off hard sync and just press play and we'll see what happens. So what's happening here? It's modulating the frequency 2 that's going into frequency 1 of the oscillators. So you already notice that there's a noticeable difference, like turn it down all the way. Another important aspect, you know, let's kind of switch over to here, is your filter section. Super important to shaping your sound. You have your cutoff and your resonance. You'll really notice how when you dial this down, it gets a little bit more flat and quieter, your sound. Versus when you open up that filter all the way. And then, you know, using resonance will really alter the sound as well, adding some higher tones, sharpness to it. Hear that. Beautiful. We're on low pass right now, and I enjoy using low pass because I feel like you get a little bit more control over it. If we kind of move on, you have some modulation stuff like your filter modulation. You have the VCF EG amount, and that's kind of like a control that controls both of these, however they're set, kind of bringing it in, bringing it out is the best way I would describe it. Let me demonstrate for you. Just just another modulation source. And it's kind of nice that you can kind of leave these alone if you wanted to, and then just kind of tweak this to bring it in, bring it out. That's kind of the use I have for it. VCF Decay will add more motion to the sound. So let's try that out. That's this guy right here. It's almost like it excites the sound a little bit more. It's like simple, nothing's going on, and then you turn that, twist that, and it's like opens up, you know, kind of more possibilities within your sound. Pretty cool. Let's talk about the white noise. So yeah, this is obviously like your mixer section. Just bring it in and it will bring in the white noise. Very simple. It'll kind of give it a little bit more of like a greater impact on the attack. It's great for those hi-hats, crashes, snare sounds. And a really quick patch that I always use, just one. I've shown this before, but I always use it. It's bringing pitch output into noise level input. And that's a really useful one when dealing with noise, because it'll kind of change it up from just being like to more like a dooch, 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 dooch. Kind of gives it more control over the sound. Let me demonstrate that for you without it. And then we'll do it with it. Kind of hear it coming in and out. Better. Cool. Your noise knob here, the VCF mod, if we slowly turn that all the way up, we'll notice that the noise becomes more used as a modulation source through the filter. You know, instead of creating depth, it makes more of a distorted sound. Let me show you. It's subtle, but it's there. Now, if we take a look over here, we have VCA Decay. This is a really important one. If you know anything about envelope generators or ADSR, you'll instantly know what this is. If not, I think the best way to describe this is kind of like right when your sound hits, you have something called decay right after attack. It hits the sound and then it kind of stays before it falls. Let me demonstrate that for you. Very quick sounds, you'll notice. And then as you twist this, the sound lasts a little longer. Quickest way to describe it. And then over here you have kind of like your attack almost, where your sound will instantly hit or it'll come in slowly. Let me show you. Yeah, I think that's the easiest way to describe that. That's kind of just a brief overview. Again, I'll save patches for another time if you guys are interested, but overall, that's kind of what everything does in a nutshell. If I miss something, let me know. Other than that, I guess you have your tempo knob, and then trigger just lets you kind of play whatever step you're on to hear it. If you wanted to tweak the parameters, pitch, you know, velocity, advanced goes to the next step. I think that's a brief overview. If you guys enjoyed this video, leave a like. Subscribe if you haven't already if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks so much for watching. We will catch you guys next time. Peace out.